So we come on this Saturday, Easter Saturday, and we gather as we always do as Christians in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
And good day to you, sisters and brothers. So we gather into this Mass now on this Saturday. All those who've asked our prayers, those we love and those who irritate us. And we, being a Saturday, we call to mind the presence of Our Lady. Saturday is a devotional day to Our Lady, the she who witnessed to her Son risen. For ourselves we pray, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us and forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, and the glorious God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the abundance of your grace give increase to the peoples who believe in you, look with favour on those you have chosen, and clothe with blessed immortality those reborn through the sacrament of baptism, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The rulers, elders, and scribes were astonished at the assurance shown by Peter and John, considering they were uneducated laymen, and they recognized them as associates of Jesus. But when they saw the man who had been cured standing by their side, they could not find no answer. So they ordered them to stand outside where the Sanhedrin had a private discussion. What are we going to do with these men? They asked. It is obvious to everybody in Jerusalem that a miracle has been worked through them in public, and we cannot deny it. But to stop the whole thing spreading any further among the people, let's caution them never to speak to anyone in these name again. So they called them in and gave them a warning and no account to make statements to teach in the name of Jesus. But Peter and John retorted, "You must judge whether in God's eyes it is right to listen to you and not to God. We cannot promise to stop proclaiming what we have seen and heard." The court repeated the warnings and then released them. But they could not think of any way to punish them, since all the people were giving glory to God for what had happened. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I praise you, Lord, for you have answered me.
I praise you, Lord, for you have answered me.
Give thanks to the Lord for his good, for his love has no end. The Lord is my strength and my song. He was my saviour. There are shouts of joy and victory in the tents of the just.
I praise you, Lord, for you have answered me.
Open to me the gates of holiness. I will enter and give thanks. This is the Lord's own gate, where the just may enter. I will thank you, for you have given answer, and you are my Saviour.
I praise you, Lord, for you have answered me.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Having risen in the morning on the first day of the week, Jesus appeared first to Mary of Magdala, from whom he had cast out seven devils. She then went to those who had been his companions and who were mourning and in tears and told them, but they did not believe her when they heard her say that he was alive and that she had seen him. After this, he showed himself under another form to two of them as they were on their way into the country. These went back and told the others, who did not believe them either. Lastly, he showed himself to the 11 themselves while they were at table. He reproached them for their incredulity and obstinacy, because they had refused to believe those who had seen him after he had risen. And he said to them, go out to the whole world, proclaim the good news to all creation. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have here an example. The resurrection stories on the faith in the resurrection is not something as if it was a conspiracy of the disciples, because time and again in the gospel accounts they don't believe it. They refuse to accept the news, as in today's gospel. They did not believe Mary, and they did not believe the two from Emmaus when they came back. And so resurrection faith is something that broke into them slowly. And it actually took an encounter with Jesus himself before that penny dropped. But from our point of view, we can look at the fact that those first two appearances after resurrection, first one was to a woman from whom seven devils had been driven out, and the second appearance was the two men who were defecting, who were abandoning the faith, leaving with heavy hearts. They said our own hope had been. They were disillusioned. So there we have it, a woman, and in the Jewish courts of the time, the testimony of a woman was not valid. And the two who were leaving had given up faith and hope in Jesus. And yet these were the first two to whom he appeared. So Jesus can appear to the most improbable people. And you and I are amongst that. We're all of us improbable people. And yet that's no reason for not believing and accepting that Jesus does appear to us through people around us, through those moments of faith and joy. As I said yesterday, you suddenly get a child smile at you, even a baby, and it's a sign of something, that hidden life, that new life, that deeper life that is at the heart of Christian and human existence, which is based through the resurrection. Let us rejoice and be glad. Alleluia. We pray for our church that it be faithful to the risen Jesus, and for Pope Francis as our Father, that he guide us in faith and wisdom. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for vocations to the priesthood and diaconate and religious life for our diocese, which is so in need of them, that they be signs of hope and service to the people of God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the families of our diocese in this time of the deprivation of the Eucharist, this hunger for the bread of life that is there, that we might deepen in our love for it, so that when the Eucharist returns to us, we might receive with great love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we make our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
And by the mystery of this water and this wine, may we be made sharers in the divine life of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our human life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we now offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, be pleased to receive us and accept the sacrifice we offer you with humble and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me from my sins. Pray, sisters and brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good and good of all his holy church.
Amen. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Easter mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to praise you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain, who lives forever. Therefore, with Easter joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. In giving thanks, he broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We profess you, proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, with me, your unworthy servant, and with all the clergy and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles, with Saint Mark, Saint Mary of the Cross, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honour is yours for ever and ever.
Amen.
So as we start this weekend, we say together now the prayer Jesus taught all Christians. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Peace be with you, peace in your homes, peace in your families. The peace of Christ risen. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. All you who have been baptized in Christ have put on Christ. Alleluia. Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those who are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now and forever.
Our help is in the name of the Lord.
Who made heaven and earth.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
And thank you, sisters and brothers. A good weekend. Tomorrow the Mass will be live streamed from the cathedral, St. Mark's Cathedral. We'll have some singing and that as well.